What's going on, everyone? It's Nick, and just had to take a little breather after my NBA predictions video because I worked really hard on that. And please watch it if you haven't yet, even though the games have already begun. But I'm here to talk about baseball now because Josh Bell has been traded to the Washington Nationals for two prospects. So before we begin, please remember to like, and if you're new, please subscribe and hit the notification bell. I cover basketball, baseball, and football on this channel, so if you like any of those three sports, this place is just for you. Also, I'm wishing everyone a Merry Christmas, or if you don't celebrate, Happy Holidays. Stay safe and enjoy. Now, this Josh Bell trade to the Washington Nationals. For basketball, we would call this a Woj bomb, but it was Jeff Passan that reported this. I don't know if we could call it anything for him, but let's not waste any time. Let's just cue the intro. So last night I was actually scripting a video about the Pittsburgh Steelers, but then Josh Bell got traded to the Washington Nationals, so I decided to react to that instead. Steelers video is probably going to come at another time, so stay tuned for that if you like football, but we're here to talk about baseball. Josh Bell to the Washington Nationals. 2019 was a monster year for him. With 37 home runs, 116 RBIs. He hit .277 with a .367 on base percentage and a .569 slugging percentage, which gives him a .936 OPS. But we're gonna get a little more analytical because the traditional numbers only give you some idea of how good a player really is, but they don't really give you the full picture. But those numbers are pretty beastly, don't get me wrong. So 135 WRC plus, really good. The league average is 100. And that was 22nd behind DJ LeMahieu. Brian Cashman, please just re-sign him already. Josh Bell's .292 ISO was 10th that year, and he had a .378 WOBA, which was 25th. And he also had a 19% K rate and a 12% walk rate. Okay, the 12% walk rate isn't anything spectacular or anything, and 19% K rate, but overall though, he had a very impressive 2019 season. But 2020, he was absolutely abysmal. Just a 78 WRC plus, 286 WOBA, a 9.9 walk rate, and his K rate skyrocketed to 26.5%. And his ISO dropped to 138. League average ISO is 140. And in fact, ISO is really a better way to calculate power because slugging percentage, singles, doubles, triples, and home runs all play into it, but ISO only calculates extra base hits, so that just gives you an idea of his power, and yeah, his power dropped off too. But because 2020 is not a great sample size, just 60 games, I got a pretty good one from MLB GMs on Instagram. They're a really good page. If you have an Instagram, follow it. 2018 to 2020, he put up a slash line of .262, .253, and .472. He had a .116 WRC plus with a .346 WOBA, 12.2 walk rate, 19.8 K rate, and a .293 BABIP. His defense was never good though. Negative 22 defensive runs saved and negative 15 UZR in his last three seasons. But if he can rake like he did in 2019, we can look past his defense easily. You can win with defensive liabilities as long as they can hit. I'm a Yankee fan, I know, and yes, I plan to make a video on Derek Jeter's defense sometime in the future. I already have that scripted. So it looks like the Washington Nationals are banking on Josh Bell to be the Josh Bell we saw in 2019. And if they get that, oh, that's a huge upgrade from Eric Thames. It will be at a low cost as he's only making $6 million this upcoming season, and then he's up for arbitration. So overall, I like this move for the Nationals. Yes, Josh Bell was abysmal in 2020, but if Josh Bell had any resemblance at all of his 2019 season in 2020, I'm sure the return for him would have been much higher. But to me, this is a low risk, high reward move for the Nationals, and also, don't forget Josh Bell is a switch hitter. As for the Pittsburgh Pirates, yeah, they've only made the playoffs once in my lifetime. Andrew McCutchen won the MVP that year. And once again, they're making another step in the rebuild direction. But how good are these prospects? Well, I actually didn't even know who these guys were before scripting this. Now, as I've done some research, okay, I missed out on the fact that Will Crow made his big league debut in 2020. He pitched three games. They did not go well at all. And Will Crow is actually only a year younger than I am. It's no time to give up on him though, as he was ranked as the Nationals' third best prospect on the MLB pipeline list. And the other guy, Eddie Yean, he's only 19 and he was ranked 6th. Yean has been with the team since he was 16. He's signed for $100,000 from the Dominican Republic and Fuzzy mentioned that Will Crow does have a top prospect card on MLB The Show, and I haven't owned a video game since high school, so if I didn't watch his video, I wouldn't have known that. So yeah, we'll just have to see how these prospects pan out for the Pirates. If Josh Bell continues to play like he did in 2020 and those prospects become studs, this is for once grand larceny by the Pirates, but I don't think Josh Bell will be that bad in a full season. And in fact, he did step it up in the last month of the season. He had a 351 on base percentage in those last 26 games. And also, we can look at how past trades have worked out for the Pirates. Like when they traded Gerrit Cole to the Astros, and while Gerrit Cole was a beast in 2015, he regressed in 2016 and 17. But when he got traded to the Astros, I'm still doing that, and I'm not stopping anytime soon when I talk about the Astros, but Gerrit Cole ended up having two of the best seasons of his career in Houston. 2019, you could even argue that he should have won the Cy Young over Justin Verlander. I would say you could have gone either way, but yeah, that's one thing of how the Pirates trading somebody absolutely backfired on them. A guy that was a star, but then had some down years. And yeah, that absolutely backfired on the Pirates. But I'm glad to have Gerrit Cole on my team now. And also, what did not work out for my Yankees, because this involved a team in my team's division, when they traded Austin Meadows and Tyler Glasnow to the Rays. And while Austin Meadows also had a rough 2020, much like Josh Bell, we've seen what he can do in 2019, which was a beast year, and he didn't do much better in the playoffs, but he did hit two home runs against my Yankees in the ALDS, which were both contributing to wins for the Rays. Although in game 5, that stupid thing on the top of the wall at Petco Park, as much as I love Petco Park, yeah, that thing on the top of the wall in right field, yeah, please get rid of that. And as for Tyler Glasnow, he had a rough 2020 as well, but 2019, he put up some really impressive numbers, but only in 12 games. We'll see what he can do in a full season. And the Rays got those guys for Chris Archer, who has not been good in Pittsburgh. So yeah, this is another trade that definitely backfired on the Pirates. And in 2020, Chris Archer didn't even play because he has some surgery. What was it again? It was thoracic outlet syndrome. Obviously, because I had to look it up and I had trouble even reading it, I haven't even heard of it, but yeah, it's definitely a trade that the Pirates lost again. And I could probably find more, but you get the point that these kinds of trades have backfired on the Pirates. And just looking at the recent history, yeah, this one probably will again, especially knowing what Josh Bell's ceiling is. And if Josh Bell does play like he did in 2019 though, yeah, the Nationals absolutely won big, no matter how good those prospects turn out. And while I don't expect him to ever be good defensively, that's okay as long as he rakes. Of course, you'd rather have a guy who can hit and field, but you'd rather have a guy who can crush baseballs than a guy who can only play defense. So yeah, those are just my thoughts on the Josh Bell trade. That's the end of this video. Please remember to like. If you haven't yet, please subscribe, hit the noties, and I'll see you next time.